I like to start a vaginal steaming session by doing a little bit of journaling so I can set intentions for the steam. What do I want from this steaming session? You can steam for many different reasons. You may want to ease your menstrual symptoms, your PMS. You may want to assist with the healing of a womb illness. You can steam to relax and just de-stress or to show yourself some love. You can steam to heal traumatic experiences like rape, toxic relationships, pregnancy loss. You can steam to heal a mother wound or any other emotional imbalance. And steaming is also good for women after childbirth because it helps a lot with wound healing, helps with relaxing. Women don't talk enough about the healing that needs to take place after giving birth, you know, so it's emotional, physical, and steaming definitely offers that type of support. So it's good to know where you want to focus your energy before you start, where you want to focus your mind during the steaming session, and also anything that you want to release. Next, I prepare the space. You don't need anything fancy. You don't need a special yoni steaming box or anything like that. You just want to be comfortable. And so all you need is some mats. If you need towels, blankets, cushions, that is it. Put the herbs in a container that can take heat. I suggest something natural like wood or copper or something ceramic. Glass is fine also, which I'm using for the purpose of this video, but definitely no plastic. The herbs that are in my Pum Pum steam are lavender. Lavender is very good for relaxing the muscles. Arnica is good for wound healing. Hibiscus is cleansing. Calendula soothes the skin. Passion flower is another very relaxing and soothing herb. Chamomile as well. Rose, very healing for the heart, opens up the heart and promotes self-love. I recommend that you do a bit of cleansing at the start as well. You know, purification is very important before doing any type of healing work to get your mind, your body, and your spirit ready. Check my video on purification. I'm gonna link it for some tips. Just sit over the bowl, make yourself comfortable. When the steam is comfortable enough that it won't burn you, stay for at least 15 minutes. Longer if you feel like it. Speak words of affirmations, you know, as it relates to your intentions. Then after, you want to release everything to the earth. Take it outside and pour everything to the earth and give thanks for your healing. Give thanks to the plants. Give thanks to yourself for taking this time. Just try to have a spirit of gratitude for all the healing that will come from this experience. I like to follow up with some more journaling. So anything that might have come up during the steam, you know, it might trigger emotions, it might trigger an experience, you know, maybe an idea came to you, whatever it is, just explore it, write it down. And sometimes, you know, it don't have to be negative emotions. Sometimes it can be negative, sometimes it can be positive, but whatever it is, just release it, let it out and put it on paper, get it out. A lot of times we store a lot of our hurt, our traumas, we store them in our wombs, and so journaling is a good way to help us to get out these things, and it's a safe space for you to express yourself. So usually after I do a steam, I like to give myself a vaginal massage and a breast massage using the Pum Pum oil, but obviously I can't do that here. So I'm going to show you how I do a womb massage using the very same oil. So I start by warming up the womb, which is important. Our womb does not like coldness. I remember somebody said, I can't remember who, was telling me that her grandmother used to tell her to take off her bathing suit after swimming before she catch cold in her womb. And that essentially translates to take off your bathing suit before you irritate your womb with the coldness. You know, we take those things for granted, but it's so important that we teach young women from early how to care for their wombs and, you know, not doing anything to irritate its wellness. So I start by taking my index finger and my middle finger and moving across from my hip bone, yes, hip bone, across to my navel. And I do this a few times and I apply a little bit of pressure, as much as I'm comfortable doing, or that eases whatever it is that I might be feeling, if I'm feeling any pain. And then I go from my thigh bone up to my navel as well. And I find this one extremely good if you are having cramps on your cycle. It's good to do before your cycle starts as well. And then I do one from my pelvic bone up to my navel again a few times. This one might feel a little bit uncomfortable, but you can release the pressure if it feels weird. And then after I do that a few other times, I just kind of freestyle, you know, whatever makes me feel comfortable, just to soothe myself, especially if I'm already on my cycle. And I think this is really good. It's good with the pum pum oil, but I think if you can use some castor oil as well, it's really good for cramps and any discomfort. Very good for women who have fibroids, PCOS, any kind of discomfort in the womb. It is good for you to do this type of exercise. My priestess sister from Barbados, when she came here earlier this year, she actually gave me one of these. So it is so good to receive it. But if you can do this on your own, it's great as well. You know, it helps really to bring back some balance and helps a lot with some of the issues that women are facing today in the womb. And it's good for digestive health as well, which is also good for the womb. Happy steaming, my sisters, and all the best on your womb healing journey. If you're interested in the pum pum oil and the pum pum steam, I'll leave the links in the description box.